Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. We're doing something a little bit different today, so let's get straight into it. Merlin. So we've got a Xbox One S here, a little bit humdrum, but it's in for repair and it needs to be done. The HDMI port is a little bit damaged there. Don't know how well that's coming through. HDMI port is definitely damaged, as you can see there. We don't have any bent pins, which is good, and the comb in the middle is looking pretty good. So I guess we can actually turn this on and just make sure it stays on a white light. So let's get that done. It does not feel good at all. In fact, I would say, yeah, the comb is pretty. That one's rock solid, and that one, yeah, definitely moving, and it's pushed back as well. The comb in the middle here is more forward. That one is definitely been pushed in. So we'll leave the HDMI out and just see if it actually powers on. Okay, we got a light and it's staying on, which is good. Just bring up the console and the capture card and just try it for the hell of it. As expected, nothing. Usually with a damaged HDMI port I would not plug it in, but that one looks sort of okay, or at least safer. There's no bent pins, so okay, yeah, we're getting nothing on that at all. Right, so let's get this apart. You guys know the drill. I'll speed run it. Oh, we could already see the dust flying off. Yeah, check that out. That's not good, is it? So we're gonna have to clean this console out before we carry on. Yeah, it's caked in it. So let's go over to the garage, get this cleaned out, and then we can carry on with the disassembly and repair, because I'm not gonna work with all this dust flying around. I always put my finger over the fan because you don't want it to spin. It's never good for a system, that. Okay, and there we go. We can actually work on that now. Working in a load of dust is no good at all. So let's get out of here and back on the workbench. Right, here we go, all nice and clean, ready to go. Right, so let's carry on with the speed run. Okay, excellent. So we have the offending article right here. Right, so I would appear to be running out of these ports. Because again, 1S's, we don't do that often due to the new generation of consoles. So let's get this port out. So we'll go 400, we'll buff that up a little bit. It is a 1S board, 430 will be perfectly fine for that. We will put a bit of flux on there just so it at least lubricates it a little bit. And let's go for it. And we just want to get some heat into the port. Again, we don't care about this port, just need to get it out safely. Okay, go at it from the bottom. Okay, it's coming loose. You don't want to pull on it. You almost just want it to fall out under its own weight. Like so. See it move? There you go. Perfect. Clean out the holes while it's still warm. Excellent. Whoops. Okay, so there's the port. We can see that it's cracked apart. Man, this thing's hot. You can get the tweezers right in there. It's all bent. Appear to have all the pads intact by the looks of it. Yep, we do. Okay, excellent. So over to the microscope. Okay, we're all in focus. So let's grab some Gutwick. Flux it up. At 355 on the T12, good enough. In fact, we can make our lives a little bit easier just by flooding that with some Kester and cleaning that tip, which is oxidized. Brilliant. Okay, there we go. Those are some happy pads. Very happy pads. We'll just wick them up, going with the grain. To be honest, I will go a bit side to side from time to time, because if there's any weak pads there, I would rather them show themselves now so I can repair them than later on. But these are all staying put. Perfect. Excellent. And again, fresh flux, clean-ish tip, and some solder. Cool, got some on the ground point there, not to worry, it's all good. Okay, let's get the port in. Turn it around so we can all see. Let's get some more flux on that. And then come in with the Axion, which has got a nice fine blade tip, but it's very dirty at the moment. Let's clean that as good as it's going to get. A little bit of solder on there, too much. Just dump some on the legs there. Yep, and we've actually bridged a couple there. Just hold that down. Okay, that looks really good. Again, clean, always clean. And we'll just inspect through the pins a little bit there, try and do the best effort. Yeah, and we've got some bridges. These Xbox ports are brilliant at bridging like that, which is okay. Essentially, just get your iron, make sure it's all clean. And just heat up the joint, ideally with the heel of the iron. Get it in there and it should clear those. Then we can use the rest of the solder on a couple of the other pins. Okay, I'm happy that's happy. Okay, at this point I think it would be diligent of us to actually buzz out those pins. Normally I wouldn't do this, but since they were there, just going to buzz them out just to be sure. So continuity mode, we get a beep when we touch the leads. Jump under the scope, no beep. So if we go here, we get a beep. Each of them pins. Good, 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 good. Cool. And yep, we're good. Right, now we can move on to the ground anchors. Now I see a lot of questions about this white stuff that's all over the board. A lot of people get it mistaken with liquid damage. It's not. I'm pretty sure it's the cleaning solution that they use at factory. I've seen this since the Xbox 360 days, so yeah, it's nothing to worry about. Right, back to the ground anchors. And we'll just flood that with a bit of flux, and then with the T12 we'll come in again, just flood it. Just push the port just to make sure it is actually flat against the board. There we go. And now we'll go in with about 360 degrees and just give the area a light heating up, which will just help the iron. We should see the solder sink through. Right, so we've got our ground anchors, we've given them a good clean, everything looks happy, those joints look really good. So we'll just move over to the top side once more, and as we can see there, solder has made it through those anchor points and we're all good. And what we'll do now is just quickly just check those pins again. They're all solid, they ain't going anywhere. Yep, that's good. Just give everything a thorough clean. Put the brush right in there. And some ESD safe blue paper towel. Just really clean it up. Excellent. And under the scope, yep. We're looking beautiful. Right, at this point we're good to test the system out. We don't need to put it all into the case. We are perfectly a-okay to do it like this. I will actually change the thermal compound beforehand, so let's just quickly do that, get that done. Okay, ugh. Yeah, that will be original thermal compound, that will. Let's just get a scraper, get that scraped off. Yeah, it's gone off like concrete, which is to be expected. This is an old console. Just get the majority of it off. Again, it's the die here that is the most important. Okay, go super nuts. This is only a 1S. Doesn't generate that much heat. Nice and clean, excellent. Grab some thermal compound when I can get the lid off. There we go. And just mate up the heatsink and board. Just a quick test squish just to make sure everything is good. Just a little bit of pressure on there. Yeah, it looks good. That corner hasn't squished, but once the clamp is on, by the time I come to test it, that would have squished out quite nice. So we're all good there. Okay, we'll just loosely reassemble this. We'll even go with the optical drive as well. Power supply. The optical drive won't bridge anything. It's good to go. Cool. So let's get the HDMI in. Yep. That feels perfect. It's exactly how that should feel. Let's bring up the console and power on. Ooh. We still have no display. That's not good. Yeah, we have no display still. Okay, let's pull that out. Try the HDMI tester. Okay, so we've got all of the lights. Power, EDID, 5 volts, and we've got the 4 data lines there. So we have full connection. So I've connected this up to the TV, as you can see. We're on input 2, and where's the info? There we go. And we've got no display at all. We've got absolutely nothing. So... yeah, I don't trust the capture card 100%, but yeah, that's why I've got this. So we're getting nothing on the display. So the only other thing to check now is the retimer IC. So let's power this down, get it back under the scope. Again, I'm not 100% sure on these. Chipmunk CMI Zapper HDMI tester. As you saw there, all the lights lit up, but we're still getting no display. So something is wrong here. TDP-159 is on the 1S, and the TDP-158 is also compatible. Get him out. And we've got a dot here and a dot there, so we need to get those lined up. And from underneath, you've got a corner cut there, so that'll signify the orientation. There we go. So we'll just put him off to the one side. Put a dab of flux next to him so he doesn't sail off into the sunset. We'll go about 400 degrees here. And here we go. Okay, that looks beautifully soldered. Before we forget, let's try and get these off. There we go. Put him to one side. And let's just give everything a quick clean. There we go, everything's beautifully soldered. So let's give it another test. Right, I think we're good to go. So the system here, plug in the power supply, give it some juice. Hard drive is okay like that. Plug that in. Let's bring up the. Okay, let's power him on. Now let's see what happens. Hey, there we go. Cool, we've got a display. So there we go, HDMI port. That was the ruined one and the TDP-159. And we replaced it with TDP-158, which also works in the Xbox One X. So that's cool. So we've got our display there. Once this is booted up, I'll move it over to the TV and we'll check it out there as well. Okay, brilliant, we're good. There we go. The TV just went into screensaver mode then, just at the wrong point, but as we can see there, perfect. And info, there we go. 1080p at 60 hertz, I think that's good. Excellent. So we can now shut this down and reassemble the console. That will conclude the repair on this Xbox One S. Not something that we repair that often anymore due to the newer generation consoles, but either way, nice to see one on the desk. If you have any issues with consoles, controllers, or any other device you feel we can help you with, please get in contact. The details are in the description below. As always, hope you enjoyed the video and take care. We'll be right back.